gentlemen and my fellow contestants. Everybody is a genius. But if you judge a fish on its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing it is stupid. This is a quote by Albert Einstein, the man who is still considered the most intelligent human that ever lived. This phenomenon of so-called being intelligent is generally believed by our society to be a person who is mostly mathematically or scientifically gifted. Am I not right? But think about it. How many school dropouts end up as successful entrepreneurs? And how many of the world's wealthiest people don't even have university degrees? This is because they possess something called business acumen, which is basically strong entrepreneurial skills. I believe being mathematically inclined is an inborn ability, automatically labeling you as intelligent. Similarly, I believe being musical is an inborn ability, but yet one has less chance of being labeled as intelligent with this. This is the classic left versus right brain battle. The human brain is divided into two halves. The left is mostly mathematical and logical, while the right is in charge of spatial abilities, face recognition, and anything creative. One side is usually more dominant. In fact, being mostly right brain is more rare than being mostly left brain. But does that make you any less intelligent? Certainly not, according to Professor Gardner of Harvard University. He proposed that people were far more complex than what a simple IQ test reveals. He suggested that people have different types of intelligence. Many types were mentioned, and people would not even consider them. The first type, and probably most well known, is of course the logical and mathematical intelligence type, which includes the scientists and computer geeks. Lawyers, writers, poets, and public speakers have high language and verbal intelligence. Artists and photographers have spatial intelligence. These people can see photos and images in a completely different way. Body and movement intelligence is found in top sportsmen. Musical intelligence is found in people with good musicality or rhythm. And intrapersonal intelligence includes the deep thinker who analyzes things. Schools often favor the language and mathematical intelligence types, although they should always strive to find a balance by incorporating the other types mentioned. In a nutshell, there is no fixed definition of an intelligent person. If I have to leave you with one thought, always remember, grades do not measure intelligence, and age does not define maturity. Thank you.